Hi, welcome to this series of videos for building the Beneteau Oceanis 37 radio control boat. I started looking for some references for this boat since this model has a special meaning for me, since this boat in a model like this was the one that I proposed to my wife. So I decided to build this boat. As you can see, it has really beautiful lines, and it's really beautiful. I previously have built other boats, like this one here. I have some images, but I have no documentation of this one. I don't have videos. And so the first thing that I did in order to build this model was looking for references on internet. I found these images from the side and top of the boat, and then I used it in a 3D software to build this cool in high definition. So I spent like a month and a half where I was having free time and dedicated to model this on 3D, the hull and the deck on high resolution. So after that, I divide this in four parts, since this is a meter and 30 centimeters of long. So I divide this one in four parts, and I create the STL files for that. So here you can see this is the front of the hull, and I designed this little holes here, like holders, to use some bolt and nuts to join it together after 3D print this part. And then using fiberglass, create the hood for this bolt. Let's jump into the printing process and the preparation of the pieces for the fiberglass.
Here I have all the whole pieces of the mold together. So after sanding, like priming, applying primer, and then sanding like four layers of that, I got a really smooth surface here. So we finished with that. Here you can compare with my size, the dimension of the project, of the whole of it. Now I have to create the template for the fiberglass. So for that, I'm going to use this trash bag, put it on the mold, and take a pattern of that, and then cut the fiberglass to do the first part of the boat. Thank you. finish with something like this. This is the pattern. So I'm thinking this for the first layer, and then I will have pieces of fiberglass like this one, because I will need more speed when I apply the material resin. So I will need more speed, and little pieces are easy to put here. So that's the plan that I'm thinking. So far, these are the two fiberglasses that I have bought. This one is 2.6 ounce, and I bought it on Amazon, but I think it's like too thin for the project. Well, I would use this one on the part that doesn't require a lot of strength, and because I have a lot, I can use more layers. And this one I got in Walmart. Doesn't say how many ounces is, but it's more dense. And I will use that in the middle part of the boat where it needs more strength for the for keep the balance with the weight on the bottom of the boat. So I would use that in combination with this one. Now for the remolding part, I will be using this product. It's a watt, and it's recommended for new molds, like applying 4 to 5 layers. So I will be applying that, so then it will be easy to demold the front of the boat from the mold. And now for the watt, I'm going to use this PVA. It's polyvinyl alcohol. And it's a product that has to be applied after the watt. And it's going to create like a little thin film between the mold and the piece. And will be even more easy to demold the piece, finish it. Thank you. that I am calculating like 3 ounces. For each ounce I need 10 drops of this. This is the one that makes the resin go hard. So I have to measure that with this weight here to do the precise mix of quantities. Paper and sand this part on the mold because it was on the corner, and also here like when using the brush for the gel coat was leaving this mark here. So next time I'm going to use a sponge one instead of a brush to do the coat. To disperse the gel coat, so I will prevent this kind of stuff, but I think this is useful. build this one with some filler. So, and then sanding it. I'm really happy with this, my first part. So, now I have to go to the middle part of the boat. But I think for the length of this video is enough until this part. So in the next video I'm going to put the middle part and the end part of the hook, and maybe I will put it all together and see how it goes. Thank you for watching.